Hey everyone, and welcome to my latest GTA 3 video. Oddly enough, even though this game is going on 15 years old, I've actually gotten a lot of requests for a walkthrough of the paramedic missions, specifically level 12. Now, any of you who have been living under a rock or in a video game equivalent of a cave for the last 15 years, the paramedic missions involve an ambulance, and they unlock infinite sprint, which is really useful to have in any Grand Theft Auto game, and they also unlock the health and adrenaline icons, which are delivered, power-ups, rather, which are delivered to your hideouts. Okay, so obviously, as the title says, this is going to be a video walkthrough of the paramedic missions with audio commentary, and I'm going to give anybody who needs it a ton of tips and tricks and methods with which to pass this mission a lot easier. This is one of the hardest things to do in this game, second only to Gripped as a mission, which is the Shoreside Vale mission in the Patriot. Anyway, if you notice that the game looks different, I'm using a mod set called Real GTA 3. I tried to install the game without the mod, but for some reason I'm having all kinds of problems removing the mod. This mod changes nothing. All it really does, in terms of the difficulty of this mission. Alright, I'll get to that in a second though. Basically, to start this mission, you press R3, and at level 1, you have to pick up one patient. Level 2, you have to pick up two patients and drop them to the hospital. Level 3, you have to pick up three patients and drop them to the hospital. And so on up until level 12. Now, where this becomes tricky and problematic is you have a time constraint. As you can see, I have 1 minute and 45 seconds on the clock. Now 41 and 40. And what makes this tricky, oh, by the way, I want to show you something here. Right by this apartment building. If you're going to take that shortcut, don't drive down it. Coast down it very slowly. Okay? And if you're going to go through here, the street construction, you can either do it serpentine like I'm doing, slowly, of course. And I'm going to show you another way to do it by backing up. I have plenty of time. Now, you can also stay to the right or stay to the left, but just be careful because the base of that tree is solid. Now, of course, I bought myself a whole host of problems because those cars are in my way, but again, I have so much time, it doesn't matter. Alright, so anyway, I'm using the... So, once you get your patients, you drive them to the hospital, and you could go... I'm going in super slow. Be careful, don't do what I just did there, because you could tip your ambulance over very easily. I'm showing you, literally, on purpose, I'm showing you what not to do. Okay, if you're going to do that. I'm using a lot of backing up and stuff, because it's only level 1. Notice I'm going in, staying on the asphalt when I do that. If you're going to go in that way, you could also go in the entrance, which is the better way, the preferred way of doing it, but if you're coming from the east, you might as well, you might as well do it that way. All right, so again, look, I'm going to drive through here, serpentine, because I've got a patient in Harwood to pick up. And again, I'm on level 2, so I'm going to grab the first two patients. This one looks like it's in Chinatown, or the red light district. I'm guessing Chinatown. The mod set that I'm using, Real GTA 3, doesn't in any way alter the physics of the game or make paramedic missions easier. If it did, I would have just either recorded this from the PS3 or used a different PC. Alright, but the mod set that I'm using here really doesn't change anything in this particular mission, so don't feel like I'm cheating here. I can do this in any version of GTA. Alright, now, you notice I passed the hospital, but I only had one patient. Now, notice you get, I got 31 seconds when I picked up a patient. That's variable. At the beginning of every level, the game decides, randomly I guess, how much time each patient and each drop-off that gives you time will give you. So now, you notice I went in differently that time, and now I'm going out. And again, if you're going to go in or out the way that I went, make sure you're not going up that green embankment, are you going to turn your ambulance over? One of the big problems with the paramedic missions is one of the things that makes it as difficult as it is the ambulance is very, very easy to turn over, doesn't handle particularly well. But one of the good things about this mission is that I chose to let that patient, to leave that patient there because I wanted to get this guy first. But one of the good things about the ambulance is it's very tough. Now I'm going down here, but notice I'm not driving down. I'm going down straight, and I sort of let the weight of the ambulance carry it down. If you're going to use those hills and things as shortcuts, like I showed you before, make sure you either know the terrain very well like I do, or you go up and down very slow. Very, very important. All right, so now, another limitation of the paramedic missions is you only have 3 seats, counting the drivers, in the ambulance. So level 1, 2, and 3, it's no problem. You can do everything in one trip. And I obviously got to stop at the blue light. And notice I'm very careful not to drive over the green embankment, not to turn my ambulance over. Okay, now I'm on level 4. So now I'm going to have to make at least 2 trips. So I could either do 3 and 1 or 2 and 2. So I'm going to grab this guy from the Trenton area. And this one, actually, I'm glad they put this patient in here. This is a pain in the ass because you got to go there and wait for Marty Chunks. I don't know if you know this. This is Marty Chunks' place. You got to wait for the gate to open and go in. All right, so if you see that, don't get faked out. Don't be like, oh my God, I can't get there. You just got to remember that that gate will open for you. Now, I can either, at any time, you can drop patients off at the hospital, but there's one thing you should know, is you only get extra time added to your clock for dropping off the first load. So if you drop, if you can't cheat the game. So I dropped off 2 only because the next 2 are really close together. I could have just easily did 3 and 1, but I got the 2 close together, and then I'm going for the other 2 that are close together. You notice the cars are all different. You know, by the way, you notice how I'm navigating. Watch the way I navigated through here and try to replicate that. You notice the cars are all different than normal GTA 3 fare. And by the way, anybody who has an objection to this, I will find a way to tape this with the regular vanilla game without the mod. But I'm promising you that nothing I'm doing here is in any way making the paramedic missions easier. It was just I couldn't uninstall the mod without having to reinstall the entire game for some reason, because I lost the original exe file for the game, and the mod takes the place of that exe file in GTA 3. Alright? Now notice one tip I'm going to give you is notice I'm not driving at breakneck speeds. I'm going quickly. Now again, watch, I'm avoiding the green and sort of wiggling in there. I'm going faster than you probably should, but alright, so now that's level 4, now I'm level 5. So now I can either, I'm best served by doing 3 and 2 or 2 and 3 patients. Now you want to hurry, but you don't want to drive like a maniac. And the reason, I'm using this particular street to illustrate how you guys should do it, because it's very easy to wreck your ambulance in there or turn it over. Alright, so now you're by the Car Crusher in Harwood, or St. Mark's, I'm sorry. Oh, it is Harwood, I'm sorry. Alright, so I'll grab that guy. And there's another one. This one's in only 2 blocks away in St. Mark's. Another thing that's very, very, very important in the paramedic mission is that you want to park far away from the patients, because if the patient runs to your ambulance and crashes into your ambulance, watch. Notice how I'm parking almost like halfway in the street. The reason I'm doing that is because if the patient runs into your ambulance while you're still moving, there's a good chance the game is going to penalize you by killing the patient, even though you're just moving at 2 miles an hour and they ran into your ambulance. So I'm going to have, so okay, so there we got those patients dropped off, and now we're going to get the last 2 for the level 5. So again, notice I'm going quickly on straightaways, but I'm slowing down around the turn using my handbrake and my regular brake. Now watch where I park. Notice I'm parking, and you notice I wasn't moving when that patient started running towards me. That is so important. I can't tell you how many times when I first was doing this, I failed the paramedic missions because I got too close to the patient. They ran into my ambulance, and somehow the game interpreted that as me running them over, even though I didn't. So remember, you want to activate the patient. If you get close enough to activate them and they can run towards you, then just stop and let them come. Alright, so that completes level 5. Alright, so now we're on level 6. So now the most rational way to do this is 3 and 3. So I'm obviously going to go for the... Now, contrary to popular belief, as the levels get higher, in some ways it actually gets easier. Because there are more patients closer together. Notice I got 26 seconds. Now here's another one in St. Mark's. Now notice every single pickup and every single credited drop-off is going to give me 26 seconds. And remember, you're only going to get credit for your first drop-off. So if you're at level 9, you're only getting credit, so you might as well try and take advantage of dropping off as many as you possibly can, because you can't cheat the game. And you see, notice where I stopped with her, and I let her run to me. You can't cheat the game by just bringing one patient at a time. See, again, 26 seconds. Once the level decides how much time you get per patient, that's what you're going to get through the entire level until you finish that level and go to the next one. Okay, here's another shortcut. You can go through this alley carefully so you don't ram your ambulance against the walls. All right, and I notice I'm going quickly, but I'm also kind of going slow when I need to. I'm not in any rush. See, I got my 26 seconds. And now I'm at a minute and 12, and every time I pick up a patient now, I'm going to get another 26 seconds. Notice I went on the sidewalk, but I was careful to avoid running people over as much as possible so as not to get a wanted level. Again, notice I stopped far away from the patient, but close enough to activate them so that they know I'm there. And I'll do the same thing here. See, that guy hit me, and not really much I could do about that. Now, also, another thing you want to do is you want to keep your ambulance in relatively good shape. You also want to know the map. That is very, 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 very important in this paramedic mission, to know the map as well as possible. So when I see the blips on the map, I already kind of know where they are. And you'll get to know them too. So you're in Trenton by the sawmill. And now watch, there's two ways to get back to the hospital. You can either make the left here, or you can make the right and go through this little dirt path. I'm showing you in the rear view mirror to show you where I am. I'm going slowly, nice and slowly. I got a minute and 26 seconds left to finish the level, so I'm not in any hurry. And all I got to do is drop these off and I'm done with level 6. So it's very important to remember, again, watch, I'm going slowly out here. So not to turn, this is one of the easier vehicles in the game to turn over and land on your roof and then you fail. Or at least the mission stops. And there are no checkpoints in GTA 3. So if you fail on your last patient at level 12 or wherever you fail, you got to start all over again from level 1. So now I'm on level 7, which means now I have to, any way you slice it, I have to make 3 trips. Because 7 is not divisible by 3. So I can either do 3, 3, and 1, 3, 1, and 3, 3, 2, and 2, 2, 3, and 3, whatever I'm going to do. Now again, just to repeat and be repetitive, since I got a lot of requests for a walkthrough on this, I want to be clear. Again, I could go to the hospital two ways. I could have either gone through that path that I showed you by purposely slowing down there, or I could have made the left, which I did. And I wanted to show you all ways. I want to try and show you all the different paths and shortcuts in this game. Okay, so notice I got 25 seconds for that drop-off, as well as I'm getting 25 for each pickup. Now, another thing I want to say that's very, very important. Notice I'm leaving that one patient there, which is it looks like it's by the super save. Why? Because I'm trying to mentally group the patients. And when I say group them, I'm talking about in groups of 3, because that's the most you can pick up. Okay? If they had 4 empty seats, I would group them in groups of 4. So now I'm going to turn around. I could have gone the other way too if I really wanted to, but I'm going to go this way. And notice I turned around really slow and I stopped there to show. I want to show you something. I want to show you how bad these. Watch how my ambulance. I'm going really slow here. If you go into that grass, the grass is hillier than it looks. I want to show you here again. Now watch. See, the ambulance looks like it's going to. If I would have sped through there, I had a good chance of turning my ambulance over. So I want to show you that. I did that intentionally to show you, and I went very, very slowly. Now I want to show you something else. Now, I can't pick up this patient here because the ambulance is full. But there's a shortcut to go through this green area by the Super Safe and the docks in Portland View. Now, notice I'm going really, really slow. I don't have to go this slow because I know the path to get through here fast. But when you are doing it, if you don't know how to get through there without turning your ambulance over, go slowly. Unless you're really running short on time. Now notice it said rescued, but I didn't get any time. That's because that was the second drop-off. You only get time added to your, and now I'm gonna, I could have gone that way, but I'm gonna show you another way to go. Again, I'm intentionally showing you different ways here. I could have made the right at that corner and then another right. Instead, I'm choosing to go back this way to show you how to get through here. Now, if you go through the middle, it's relatively flat, but not completely flat. So go slowly. I've turned my ambulance over in that terrain behind the hospital and in front of Super Save more times than I can tell you. And one time I even turned it over at level 12. Now again, I'm staying by the divider, and that makes it a little easier. But again, and I'm gonna show you this again. I'm gonna go back to show you different ways of getting through here, okay? All right, you can stay to this side. So now I'm again by the Super Save. I'm not driving like an idiot here. I'm doing this intentionally to show you different ways to get through here. All right, look how the ambulance wants to turn over in that. Look at that. If I would have rushed through there, my ambulance may well have turned over. All right, I still got 40 seconds left, so I'm going to show you another pitfall of this terrain. So again, if you're going to go through here, make sure you go slowly. I'm not even worried if it starts counting down because I've got plenty of time to get back to the hospital. So I'll back up here. Now I'm going to go dead center. Watch this, right by these two trees and straight through. Notice how that was relatively flat when I went through dead center. So if you know you're going dead center, you can go quicker because it's a relatively flat terrain. So get to, okay, so that's level 8. Cool. So now we're on, I'm sorry, that was level 7. So now we're on level 8. I get faked out looking at the, now watch, I'm going to go through this the other way. I'm not going to zigzag through here. But here, be careful because it's very easy to run the patient over. So I stopped and let him come to me. I didn't want to even take a chance. So now, when you're doing 8, you obviously can't do 4 and 4. What are you going to do? Are you going to do 3, 3, and 2? Well, that's really the, or 3, 2, and 3, or 2, 3, and 3, but... Now, notice I'm grouping. Notice I went for these three first. Now, here, the game is being really generous. I'm getting 34 seconds per pickup here, so I'm just going to be lavishing in time soon. And I'm also going to get 34 seconds for my first drop walk, but not my second, remember, just the first. Okay, this time I went through the other road, and if you come through this road, you got to make the left, the right, and then the left. Now I'm going to go through this little wiggly shortcut here, but again, notice I went through slow and stayed off the embankment so I don't turn over. So now we're going to go for the next bridge. And I'm noticing that we've got one in Trenton, it looks like one in Chinatown, and then this looks like, I forget what, by the way, I'm doing the commentary after the fact, so I'm not sure how I group these, if you're wondering. Okay, so that gave me another 24 seconds, and again, just to whip the proverbial dead horse, you notice that I am getting 24 seconds with every time I get a time credit. And again, notice I'm grouping the patients because this is level 8, so I'm trying to do 3, 3, and 2, or, you know, I'm always mindful of how close I am, or relatively close, because unfortunately, unlike Vice City and San Andreas, you can't pause this game. Let me show you something here. Well, I'm going to go through the walkway here, right? But again, I'm going slower than I have to. I would recommend you going slow. Now, you notice I'm not running into any time pressure. Okay, I'm not running into any time pressure, and my ambulance is in really good shape because I'm taking good routes to get to things. That's half the battle on these paramedic missions. Again, slowly through here. Well, I went a little faster, but if you get used to it like I am, you can go quicker. All right, so notice I didn't get time for that. Okay, so now I've got two more to pick up on this level. But I got a minute and 8 seconds, and I'm 5 seconds away from a patient. So, I'm not worried about the time here at all. Now, here, I'm anticipating that I have to go back. And notice that when I did move, I was really moving slowly. If you're moving any quicker than that when the patient comes up to you, you're going to end up getting charged with running them over. Now, again, notice I'm going through dead center, but there was still a little... I wasn't quite dead center. I should have been to the right a little bit. But there was a little bit of a nice... See, look at that. I almost turned over. I could have turned over there, too. And there, I wanted to show you that. There, I was on a hill, just turning around really fast was able to turn me over. So you want to be mindful. Now, here, I'm going to try to go through dead center. Notice it's relatively flat if I'm to the left and the right of those two dividers. Midway between the police department and the cab company, I think that is. All right, so level 9, that gives me a health pickup, but I don't care about that because you're going to get that anyway on your way to level 12. So now we're going to do, the only way to really do this effectively is to go 3, 3, and 3. Now, as much as you might think, oh my God, look how hard this is, and by the way, I got 25 seconds per patient, a little cheap, but whatever, but notice how many patients are scattered, those green dots are all over the map. So it makes it, believe it or not, in some ways these higher levels become easier. Not completely, but in some ways, only because it makes it easier to kind of visually group them into groups of three. Like I kind of know that patient, I knew from the moment that I was down in Harwood that patient would be my next pickup and it was going to be by Salvatore's mansion. I just knew it. You know, because I know the map very well. All right, like those patients, if you look to the top of the radar, I know that those four patients I'm seeing there to my radar left now are all going to be in Trenton and Atlantic Keys and all that area. All right, the ones behind the ambulance are going to be in the red light district and maybe Harwood, not so much Harwood, but okay, so yeah, now I'm gonna grab this one. Notice I'm trying to stay in the area with the patient so I can do the 3, 3, 3, and 3. So again, notice every single one of my 9 pickups plus the one. So I'm gonna leave that one there behind the hospital because look at these two are close together, right? So I mean, I'm gonna get a lot of time added to my clock just for these two patients. I'm gonna get 50 seconds within a relatively short amount of time. Oh, I wanna show you something else too. I pulled away to activate that patient, but I pulled away too fast. I did that intentionally, so you'll see. If you're gonna do that, you gotta pull away slower so the patient will actually follow you. So you can't cheat the game in that way. Again, I did that intentionally for you. All right, so now 137 seconds. No problem, we're not running short on time at all. Notice I'm not getting any time to the clock. Slowly out through that exit. Okay, now I'm gonna go towards the red light district where those other two patients, at least I'm estimating they're in the red light district. Oh. And this one is in Hepburn Heights, okay? So I estimated wrong, but kind of not. Hepburn Heights and Red Light District really overlap. Or not overlap, but they're adjacent. Now look, you notice how you can go through here, but there's a lot of obstacles to trip on, so just if you're going to go through this little park area, be careful. Notice how, I mean, the ambulance is dented up a little bit, but in real life this would suck, but in GTA terms, this ambulance is in pristine condition. So yeah, it's very important to keep your ambulance in as good a shape as you possibly can. But you don't have to go crazy. The ambulance, I guess Rockstar intentionally made the ambulance. Notice I'm not going to the hospital because I still got one more patient to go. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to group these all into groups of three. So I've got this one orphaned guy way out in Trenton. But whatever, I mean, I'm going a little quick to show you that you can navigate those roads quickly, but don't drive like that unless you can. Better to slow down a little bit, as long as you're not running out on time. There's a couple of ways to get to the hospital from here. I'm just going straight on. Alrighty. So, I finished that with a minute to spare. I mean, that was, you know, so now I'm going to level 10. So now, from 10, 11, and 12, you got to do 4 drop-offs, which means you got to do 3, 3, 3, and 1. You can do 3, 3, 2, and 2. Any order, any, and always, believe it or not, now I'm going to grab these two here. When, believe it or not, whenever I do the paramedic missions on a new GTA 3, San Andreas, and now notice that one I wanted to illustrate like I did before. I was close enough to both of them, I was able to sort of park in between them. And I got 27 seconds each, so now I'm really just lavishing in time. Notice I parked far away from him. All right, so notice I'm taking my sweet time. I'm not driving like a maniac. Alright, but remember for 10, 11, and 12, you've got 4 drop-offs. Now again, I'm going slowly through here, even though it's relatively flat, just to show you that you can go quicker if you find that sweet spot through there, but you probably don't want to, unless you really know the game well. And I'm playing this game, when I'm playing this paramedic mission, I'm sort of pretending I'm a noob at GTA. I'm sort of pretending I don't know the game as well as I know it. And backing up and doing stuff intentionally to show you. Well, that was kind of annoying. Oh, there's another thing you should know. When you've got patients in the ambulance, every time you bump the ambulance, you get a little tiny time penalty. Now, this was really convenient. Look at this. All 3 patients within a block of each other. The 2 of them are by the auto showroom, and then you got 1 that's going to be behind the firehouse, which, you know, and you can't beat that with a stick, right? 27 seconds each patient. That's nice. Don't use any of these ramps when you're doing the paramedic missions. Can you? Yes. But you really want to take a chance on turning your ambulance over. Nothing more frustrating than getting to 10, 11, and 12 on any one of those levels, being late in it, and then just you just get lazy, or you know, you do something dumb and turn your ambulance over. I got 2 minutes and 30 seconds, and I'm not really worried about time. I zigzagged through there quicker than I would if I was were you guys and didn't know the game maybe as well as I do. And again, slowly through here. Notice I didn't get any time because that was my second drop off in the level. So now mentally I've got these grouped. So now I'm gonna grab this guy in Chinatown. And then there's another 2 in Chinatown also. Actually, I'm looking at the radar. It looks like they're in Chinatown, but in reality, one of them could be over by Atlantic Caves, too, or even by the Callahan Bridge. But I'm guessing the both are in Chinatown based by the way the map is moving, and I'm right. Okay, so I kind of anticipated that the 3 of those patients would all be in Chinatown. Okay, so now, I mean, you notice how even though it gets harder in some ways in the upper missions, the patients are often so close together, you could really group them nicely. And I'm really able to, I really got, so far I got all nice groups of 3 and 3 and 3. So now I just got to get 2 more after this. And there's a little shortcut through here, but just be careful by that laundromat or dry cleaner, whatever it is. So remember, I wanted to show you that. You can go through that, or you could just go around. You know, you're not going to, it's not going to, what are you going to gain? 2, 3, 4 seconds? All right. Did I say 2 there? Where there's only 1 in St. Mark. But notice I left this 1 in St. Mark. He's like kind of the orphaned patient. So I'll grab him. Now again, I'm stopping nice and far away from him. Another thing too, if you're looking to save time, another tip for this. Once the patient, now this isn't true in San Andreas, you can actually lose him. But in this game, in GTA 3, once the patient opens the door, technically, the game sees them as already in the ambulance, and you can take off. Notice that I should have mentioned that before, and I didn't. Okay, I'll mention that again in the next level. Okay, so now we're done with patient with level 10. I'm not worried about the money because this just, you know, who cares. Now we got to go to level, and I'm showing you that again, what not to do. See? I'm just be careful. I showed you that 4 or 5 times intentionally. So now we're at level 11, which means we're going to do 3, 3, 3, and 2, or 3, 2, 3, and 3, or 2, 3, however you want to do it. But again, I'm mentally grouping these and doing a little arithmetic going, all right, there's 3, there's definitely 2 here, and there's a 3rd one there, so I know exactly which 3 I'm going to be getting. If there were only 2 in St. Mark's, I'd be like, all right, screw it, I'll grab the 2 from St. Mark's, bring them back first, and get my time, and then I will get the... See, now I'm leaving the ones in Harwood because that... Notice that mentally I grouped those 2 in Harwood with the same one that was by Hepburn Heights or the Red Light District. So mentally I'm kind of getting a picture of where... Since you can't use a pause map in this like you can in Vice City and San Andreas, I sort of mentally know that those 3 are nicely placed in the same general area. Isn't that cool? So now we've got... These 3 dropped off. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to look to head to grab these closest to the hospital. Now, if you're short on time, sometimes getting the closer patients is your best strategy. In this instance, I was like, screw it, and I wanted to show you alternate ways. Now, in retrospect, watching this video as I do the recording, I probably should have gone a little differently in this mission, but I also want to show you that this isn't total brain surgery either. You don't have to be perfect about how you group your patients, especially when you've got more than a minute on the clock and you know with every pickup you're going to be adding X amount of time to your clock. Alright, so this wasn't the worst grouping of patients that I did, but it gets a little ambiguous sometimes, again, without the pause map. So let's just grab these two, this drop off, and notice I'm not going to get any time added to my clock, so you can't cheat the game by making multiple drop offs. Now, I'm going to go for those 3 that I described before. Now, I sort of knew mentally that 2 of them are going to be in Harwood. Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Coca-Cola truck. I don't know what that vehicle is in the real game, but again, this is the modded game. And again, I want to be clear. If anybody has any objections to me doing the walkthrough with this, I'll be more than happy to do another video with just the vanilla game. Trust me, there's no difference. I just like playing with real GTA 3 because I've been playing with this for so long. So now I'm going to go down this little semicircular road. I want to show you another cute little shortcut. I actually showed you this before, but I'm going to show it to you again. Slowly up here because it's very easy to turn your ambulance over. Now, there's 2 ways you can go to the hospital from here. You can either go straight down this road and go through Hepburn Heights and the Red Light District, but I'm not going to. I'm by head radio station, although here it's CNN. That's pretty funny. Now, remember, if you're going to go through here, don't drive. Let the weight of the ambulance carry you down that little embankment. Cannot tell you. And the same thing going up, by the way. I have plenty of time, so I'm going to show you how to go up this, too. Again, this is just to show you. Okay, notice I went up very slowly. I can't tell you how many times when I first started playing this game, and even years after, that I flew up or down that little embankment, and what did I do? I turned my ambulance over on level 11 and wanted to kill somebody because I had to start all over again. Feel free to laugh at my pain. But okay, so this is the other way to get to the hospital. Okay, again, I wanted to show you that shortcut in case you wanted to use it, not that you had to. Again, I'm showing you what not to do intentionally. Okay, be careful of that. You know, I'm hammering this home because let me tell you something, it's a big concern in this game. Okay, these little embankments and they don't, the 3D imaging in this game is not perfect. Is that you may be chugging along, thinking you're on a flat stretch of green and not seeing the fact that, you know, because of this is 2001 PS2 technology, in this case ported to the PC, sometimes the imaging of things like hills and bumps and rocks and, you know, stuff like that, like to the right where you're seeing, it almost looks flat. I'm going to show you this again, intentionally. I'm going to show you this here. It almost looks flat to the eye, but it's not. Now, obviously, Grand Theft Auto and all video games have come a long way. So just know, when you're going through those areas that almost kind of sort of seem flat, They may not be. And just be mindful of the fact that, like, I'm going to cut through here. Now, I could just go to the corner and make a left and another left because I got 49 seconds. But notice, be mindful of the fact that there's little, almost invisible divots in the road that can turn you over. Now, I realize I'm whipping a dead horse now. I must have said that about 9 times in this video. But it bears mentioning because... Okay, now we're on level 12. All right, so now there's only one way to really do this effectively. 3, 3, 3, and 3. So, but the patients are so close together, there's actually a lot of margin of error if you keep your head about you. Okay, so I'm going to grab this one, and I'm going to grab the two that look like they're in the red light district, and, well, actually, they're both in the red light district. I don't think the other one's in Hepburn Heights. So you notice I'm kind of mentally grouping them already. You know, but I'm doing so while moving. Not trying. So it looks like to the right on the radar, it looks like there's three patients up by St. Mark's and or Harwood. But I'm obviously not going to worry about them now because I can only get three at a time. All right. So now again, I want to show you another thing I mentioned before. Whipping another dead horse. I parked very far away from him. And notice that I started taking off the second he opened the door. Now you got to keep your GTA straight, because if you do that in San Andreas, you could kill the patient by taking off. But in GTA 3, once the patient opens the door, the game sees that patient is already in the ambulance. I'm going to show it to you again here. This is working out really nice. Not only do I have a minute on the clock, but I've got a bunch of patients here. Now watch, I'm taking off, right? Taking off before he's even in the ambulance. As long as he's opened that door. Another thing you might want to do, and I found this to be marginally effective, or at least somewhat effective for saving a little bit of time, is that sometimes when you know that, for instance, that you put a patient in the passenger side next to you, then the next patients you want to pull in such a way, watch what I'm going to do there. I'm going to show the patient the rear of the ambulance, making it easier. So I knew there that my only empty space was going to be in the rear, so instead of pulling right up next to the patient, I pulled up in such a way that the patient could get through the rear of the ambulance quicker. If my only open seat was in the front passenger side, I would have gotten that end of the ambulance closer to the patient. These are all just stupid little things to make this easier. Again, I'm going to show you this again. I've got time, so I'm intentionally showing you what not to do here. I'm going to rename this video the Whipping a Dead Horse video, because I've said it so many times. But I'm only doing it for your own good, because I can't tell you how many times I've turned my ambulance over in this. Now watch, I'm going to just fly through this because I know this well. I would suggest you proceed a little slower until you know this well, as well as, at least as well as I do at this point. Alright, so now we are chugging away at level 12, which is cool. We'll grab this guy. Now notice again, I had the empty seats in the rear, so what did I do? I showed him my rear. Alright, because I knew there was a guy in the passenger seat already, in the front passenger seat. Oh, another cutesy thing. Now again, I'm going to show this guy my rear. I made a mistake there. I actually thought that my rear seat was empty, but no big deal. He just ran around. But notice I lost about 2 seconds. Not that it really matters in this case, because my time is so effectively used already. But just little things like that can be the difference between passing and failing, between the clock running out and not. And the mistake that I just made there, and by the way, I didn't do that intentionally. I want to tell you something else. If you have 125 health, and you sit in the ambulance, it'll drop you back down to 100. I guess the game doesn't really deal well with the hooker trick to get you to 125 health. Sitting in the ambulance adds health to you if you're under 100, but if you're over 100, it'll take away your health and drop you back down to 100, for whatever that's worth. All right, so the final two patients in the level, I'm going to do it through here. Now, I pointed the ambulance to another way I could go, so I could have gone through there to the right, but I could go through here. I've got plenty of time, so I'm just showing you different alternate routes here. Okay? And slowly, slowly. All right? You don't want to be running patients over now, especially if you get to the last patient and you do something stupid. Now, I could, to the hospital, I can actually go back, or I can go forward and make a left here, or I'm going to go the other way, just to show you. I'm going the long way on purpose, just to show you that you can get there this way as well. Again, going behind the hospital, in front of the Super Save, and you're going to come out by the police station, right? All right, so I'm again, I got plenty of time, so I'm going to show you this through here you could go. You can orient yourself to go straight through here, like I'm doing now. And notice it's not so many bumps, but enough. All right, so now we'll just drop your patients off. All right, now you got level 12. You've got infinite run. And you've got the adrenaline power. Okay, I'm going to splice this part in there because there's a couple of spots that I didn't have patients in during the walkthrough video. So I want to show you how to get to them because they're very difficult, especially this first one. Also, notice I reinstalled the game and took the mod off. So I could, if upon request, it I could recreate or redo this video with out the real GTA 3 mod, even though it doesn't change anything. So here, the triads are shooting at me now. This is very often you'll get a patient in that basketball field, which seems at first glance like you can't get to it. Okay, you don't have to go all around, like all the way around like I'm going. You could just like go right up onto the grass or right up into this lot. I just wanted to show you that you can go all the way around. You can now, if you go, you can either use that ramp to get in, or you can break down this gate, because this entire fence, not the concrete, but the metal fence surrounding this, is destructible. So the first way to get in there is the way I'm going to do it first. Very slow, very straight, use this ramp. See that? Very slow, very straight. And you can pick up the patient, and then you can use the ramp to get out. Easy, right? But, you know, you may not realize that at first. The other way to get in is just crash your ambulance through the gate, like I just did there. Even though I got deflected because I didn't hit it straight on, the fence is still destroyed, and I can still get in there without damaging the ambulance too much. One thing that's very, very important I didn't mention during the main video is you want to... I'm going to go get another ambulance because the triads blew this up. You want to do this mission before the triads or the mafia hate you, because they'll shoot your ambulance up as they did here. So do it before Trial by Fire, which is an El Burro mission, and do it also before the Tony Cipriani mission where you have the gang war, because the triads will just shoot your ambulance up. All right, now notice I'm crashing right through here. Let's pretend there's a patient in there. Right, I grab the patient and I can either, again, use that ramp to get out, or use this spot here. I think if your ambulance isn't in such great shape, then try to use the ramps. There's another spot, which by the way is at the end of another El Burro mission called the Big and Veiny, which is behind the porn store. And sometimes you'll get a patient in that three-way alley, and you can't activate the patient or get the patient to come out from the street. So the best way to do it there is to slowly, because they're usually on the very edge of the alley, you slowly back in and let the patient get in themselves. All right, so let's get back to the rest of the video from this splice. So you've completed level 12, or I have, rather, you will. Now, just for a heads up, whenever I do anything with these missions, the first thing I'm going to do, I've got into the habit of doing this, I'm going to take this ambulance to the emergency vehicle crane right in the Portland docks. Why am I doing that? Well, because if you turn over all the emergency vehicles at the, once you get the tank and, I think there's six of them, there's the ambulance, the fire truck, the police car, the barracks OL, the tank, the SWAT van, am I missing anything? Oh, the FBI. So it's seven vehicles, it looks like. It's seven vehicles. Once you get all them to this crane, which was where I'm bringing it here, notice it. Just look in the map and you'll see it's right by the ship, right by those two containers. And once you deliver all of them, and obviously the tank you're not going to have access to unless you use a cheat code, and the FBI And the other vehicles you're going to need to be have access to at least Staunton Island and Shoreside to a point to get the tank, and Staunton to get the other two. Well, once you get all seven, not only do you get cash, which is completely useless in this game for the most part, but you also get the GTA pickups in that same location where you can go there anytime you want and get a tank for free, or get an FBI car, or any emergency vehicle, just like, it works exactly the same as the import-export garages. Now, the video is going to cut off here. I'm not quite sure what happened and why I lost the, but you get a $1,500 payout and a message to bring the rest of the vehicles, blah, blah, blah. Just the same, again, same as the import-export garages. All right, so anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. A lot of people were requesting a walkthrough for the paramedic missions, similarly to my other walkthroughs on YouTube. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it again, and everybody have a great day, and I shall see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.